We're working through all the lessons on the Bernina 570. And today we're working with decorative stitches. And as you know by our wonderful Bernina Stitching Cosmos online course, I love decorative stitches. So here's the thing about decorative stitches. When you are looking at the screens on your machine, the stitches look okay. But let me tell you, when you take the time to stitch them out, like I have here, plus I'm going to show you the little tips and tricks that you need to know about stitching decorative stitches, they come to life. So on this machine, you have an entire area of decorative stitches hiding in the little decorative stitch tab. And in each one of those folders, there's even more stitches. So as you touch on it and either scroll up by touching and dragging or touching this little arrow here to expand the whole entire menu, which still lets you scroll up until you find all the stitches, we talk about the beauty of stitching all these stitches out. We call it making a stitch book. And we have links below this YouTube video where you can watch me show you how to make the ultimate stitch book. This is also a great way to get familiar with your brand new machine or become refamiliarized with it because you've forgotten all these wonderful things in it. Like, I didn't even know we had a palm tree in this area. I do see it in the stitches 175, plus a whole bunch of other fun ones too. So I guarantee they look so much better stitched out in thread. You'll probably enjoy having your open toe foot. This is the foot 20C that came with the Bernina 570 Quilter's Edition because we do use it for applique and things like this. So I would just say start at the beginning, pick stitch number one and stitch it out. So what I've been doing is number one, I'll take some fabric. You do need some stabilizer. So like right here where it's kind of gotten a little wrinkly, I don't have enough stabilizer for this particular fabric. So I'm actually going to add another layer of tearaway stabilizer. In our Stitching Cosmos online course, we always talk about using two layers of stabilizer so you get the best results. So what I'm going to do is just line up the presser foot right next to the last row of stitching. You can step on your foot control or you can use the start stop button by touching and holding the green button until it actually starts to sew. You can adjust how fast the machine stitches by moving the speed dial up or down. And let's go ahead. Wow, that is fast. And then what I like to do is just go ahead, keep the edge of that foot along that last line of stitching as it stitches out. I have palm trees. That is amazing. All right, as I get close to the end, we're going to be touching the pattern in button. Now in the settings, I do have this set up to not only in the pattern, so I'm going to push it right now, so I'll finish that palm tree. It will finish the pattern, lock, and then it'll also cut and lift the foot up. So that's going to make it really easy as you start to work your way through all the stitches and stitching out your own stitch book. See how much more fun that is when you see them stitch out on the fabric than on the machine? Now, if you are loving what you're seeing, join us in the Bernina Stitching Cosmos online course where we take you through 25 different sewing techniques, all using decorative stitches, so you can really master your machine. We even use them in places you don't even realize that you have opportunities to use them for. Couching, twin needle, all sorts of techniques. And there are over 10 videos that you can watch for free and check out and see if this course is right for you. So click at those links below and click like if you've made your stitch book and you know how great of a resource that is.